get a quick score, get to the free throw line to give them two opportunities to one.
Pippen into Jordan. Michael working on Russell. Brings them to within one.
They scored within 4 seconds there. That's how quickly that changes now. Now it puts the pressure on the Jazz to score once again.
Jordan with 43. Malone is doubled. They swat at it and steal it. Here comes Chicago. 17 seconds. 17 seconds from game 7 or from championship number 6. Jordan open. Chicago with the lead. Timeout, Utah. 5.2 seconds left. Michael Jordan running on fumes with 45 points.
Russell comes in to Stockton. Stockton, 4 seconds. Stockton, a three up out front. Rimming, no. Ball tipped away. Chicago is world champions once more. The Chicago Bulls have won their 6th NBA championship in the last 8 years.
They call a flagrant foul on Kurt Thomas right there as he threw Rodman down, and then he grabs him. You know, Dennis Rodman really was just a spectator through all that. I mean, we talk about Rodman all the time, but he had nothing to do with what happened there, Bob.
No, he was an innocent party, at least in that exchange. Flagrant foul on Kurt Thomas. Technical foul on Rick Fox of the Lakers.
Here for the flagrant.
As he hits it.
Now see, you got a flagrant one, which is 2 shots, and then a flagrant 2, which is 2 shots in the ball and ejection.
1 of 2.
He's out of bounds, he'll hit the line. Good, deep, running, technical on Rodman. Good job.
Number 70, Dennis.
Rodman wanted an illegal defense. That's what he's upset about it. He's still talking about it.
Rodman sits and he's gone. Rodman's gone. He sits down in the lane as if to say this is where the man was positioned, and Dennis Rodman has been tossed in his second game back. And second game with the Mavericks. It didn't take long, did it?
No, you knew it wouldn't.
Over the course of his career, Rodman has paid $163,000 in major fines.
This one's going to go up because he's staying in his space.
Yep. He won't leave.
In the meantime, Jim, you know how he's hurting his team right now? They're losing.
Rodman has gone off.
In the meantime, he's lost focus of them winning this ball game. They were coming. They were playing some good ball.
And off comes the jersey. So the show continues.
Now, you hold the key here to these team returning. Michael said if you come back, he'll come back and fill in so forth. What are your thoughts? Will you come back? Would you take a one-year deal? What will go through your thought process in making this determination?
Well, Jim, right now, I just have to, you know, let everything soak in. You know, there's a lot of opportunities out there for me, and, you know, I have to look more down the road at my future, but, you know, I don't know. You know, after all this soaks in and get back and get my back on track, you know, you never know.
Is there a twinge of sadness with you, a little melancholy feeling right now that it may be ending?
Excuse me?
Are you feeling a little sad right now that this could be coming to a close?
No, not really. You know, we're going to enjoy this and, you know, as long as we can. You know, as a player right now, I don't feel like it's over. You know, we got a lot of celebration to do, and I'm not really looking forward to next season.
Thanks for the big rebound. Missed 2, Lakers by 2. It's Kobe again. A 20-point swing. Once down by 16, they lead by 4. Exactly a minute remains. Pippen for 3. Portland has 3 timeouts left. The Lakers have two. Bryant to Shaq. Dunleavy's reaction not only understandable, but perfectly justified. He was fouled.
That could be the season right there.
Let's talk to Phil Jackson. Once again, another journey to the top of the mountain. How is this one different from the other five?
Well, Ahmad, we had to fight our way through this one. This is a real struggle for us this year against overwhelming odds. Maybe not as talented as the last 2 years, but they had a great heart. Hearts of a champion, as Michael has said. They won it.
All right, you will celebrate tonight. Are you going to come back?
That's a great question, Ahmad. I'll dodge that one right now. Thanks.
All right, Phil. All right, once again.
Jackson looking to throw it in against Shaq. Reggie turns and pumps it up. Off the rim, and the Lakers are the 2000 NBA champions.
First of all, I want to thank Phil Jackson, the real coach of the year.
They fell in love with this team, Marv. This is a city that wants you to give their heart and soul. You see Phil Jackson congratulating the various teams. He went over a sign of respect to Dikembe Mutombo, but what a moment. I can't even imagine. Phil Jackson, 8 championships. What he has done as a coach, this team, they have responded. What a moment for the city of Los Angeles and for these Los Angeles Lakers.
There were a lot of times during the course of the season that people doubted the Chicago Bulls, doubted that you'd be able to come back and pull this off. Even during this this finals series here, people doubted you. How'd you guys stay so confident?
Well, I mean, this team is one. Our leadership is strong. Our leadership is very positive, very determined, and it filters down to the rest of the players. And we never let anybody give up. You know, we believed in it, and we kept coming for it.
All right, I've asked everybody if they're all going to come around to try to do this again one more time.
I would love for that to happen. I think that's something that's got to have to be determined over summer.
All right. Congratulations, Michael. Congratulations, Chicago Bulls. Let's go.
Oh!
Oh!
When was the last time you were in this building?
We was retirement. It's been a while. Yeah. I haven't been here since.
How'd it feel out there? How much of your game you still got left?
None. Half court and I'm wore out. There's the good thing about it, he's wore out more than I am.
There's no chance in ever. Right? Oh, come
on. None at all. I mean, today was just a break of sweat. You know, see some of the guys, try to help the morale a little bit. You know, no one asked me, you know, Tim asked if I could stop out sooner or later. You know, I just got back in town. I decided to stop by. No one else has asked. You know, I came by to see Dickie and some of the other guys, and please don't take it no further than that.
What are you happy with your life and what you're able to do?
I'm going back and pick up my kids right now, so, you know, it's just a little break until I can get back and pick them up. So, I mean, it's full enough. I got enough opportunities on my plate. I got enough challenge with golf. I got enough challenges elsewhere. I mean, I had my great reign in basketball. No matter what you guys say, or if I come and hang around the game, because I still love the game, that doesn't mean I'm coming back to it.
Are you going
to
buy a team eventually?
If it ever comes up, every good opportunity to come up, I will.
Mike, in those fleeting moments when you do think about maybe playing again, what color uniform are you wearing? Is there ever any?
Never that thought. You know, I don't sit back and you know, second guess my decision. When I made the decision, it was never going to be a second guess. You know, and you know, so when I think about basketball, I think about the talent that's playing right now. You know, I may reminisce about some of my other players that I played with, Tony, some of the guys I missed playing the game. But every uniform I see is a Bulls uniform. I've never seen myself in another uniform.
I'm not afraid to take on a challenge. I'm not afraid to take a step.
The debut of Michael Jordan in a Washington uniform. Jordan takes the jumper and knocks it down. Jordan lays it in.
It was tough guard beat back then, and it still is tough to defend me now.
Here's Jordan in the post. He'll let it fly.
He still has it. I watched the game and he got 41.
Jordan, yes! He has caught fire! It's
been a while since I got in that rhythm.
A three for Jordan!
I gave you guys a dunk. Y'all been begging for a dunk. I even dunked the ball. I'm not bad for a 38-year-old man. Well, the young dog's gonna chase me around.
This is Jordan with the ball guarded by Vince.
Well, I'm not gonna block too far away from them either.
In the block, right post. It's Jordan, puts it on the floor, spinning, turning, shooting, and scoring! Michael Jordan!
Paul, he's been looking forward to that challenge. Quite frankly, I have too. He's a young kid, and I'm actually looking to come at me hard.
And he's playing Paul Pierce. Little rock move there. Crossover gets his shooting hand free. That was not an easy shot.
We will resume this, I think, November 7th. I'm pretty sure. But he's got to realize I'm coming at him, too. So November 7th should be a good game.
I am here to announce my retirement from the game of basketball. I've accomplished everything I could as an individual. I chose to walk away knowing that, you know, I can still play the game. Physically, I can't say that I'm any less than 99 right now because I haven't played for 3 years.
MJ can't be pleased with his squad's performance.
At 38, can I possibly come back and play at a level of basketball that, you know, that I left the game? You know, the odds are that I probably can't.
Right in the hands of Jordan, who anticipated.
Some people wouldn't want to see me out there playing, you know, because they have a perfect perception of how my career should end.
The Chicago Bulls have won their sixth NBA championship.
But ultimately, they don't get up and look in the mirror and say, hey, you know, what if?
Speculation has ended. Rumors confirmed. The greatest player of all time is back, and he's wearing a Wizards uniform.
Who would have ever thought that 99.9% would have come to fruition in this way?
Well, I mean, you know, there's a reason why I didn't say 100%, you know, and you never know, you know. And when you say that, never, you know, you better be sure that, you know, things are 100% that way, you know. And I couldn't because of my love for the game, but I was pretty sure, you know, when I left the game in 98, I was, you know, pretty sure that I wouldn't come back to the game, you know, 99.9% sure.
Hey, Mike, I got your book, you know.
For you personally, having been gone for 3 years, what's it like being back in the arena? Were you a bit nervous the first time?
I'm nervous in every arena that I go in because I know and I can feel the expectation of the fans. And I've learned in the years of playing the game of basketball is that you're never going to be able to live up to what their expectations are. You know, so I have to set my own expectations and live up to those. And hopefully at the end of the day, we all are happy.
Are you 100% happy that you're back?
Yeah, I'm happy I made this decision. I don't regret it. You know, things happen for a reason. you know, I am just following the path that, you know, it's kind of been bestowed upon me, and I know it's going to lead me to wherever it's going to end, you know, and I will appreciate everything that I've accomplished thus far.
Trying to go inside, Michael spins, it's gone.
And Michael looked over at us and said, he can't guard me. He can't guard me.
You had the utmost confidence. Your confidence level was through the roof. Where is it now?
On top of the roof. I don't think my confidence changed. I wouldn't have come back into this situation lacking any confidence that I can play this game. And I know I can play this game. And I know I can play it at the highest level and successfully. So I haven't lacked any confidence. You know, I still think I can get on the brink of cockiness, you know, because of my experience. But, you know, I haven't lost respect, though. I respect every opponent that I play, you know. And I imagine that they were going to have to respect me, too. So, you know, I'm confident, but I'm not overconfident.
And you say, well, the young dogs are going to chase me around. Well, I'm not going to bark too far away from them either. You know, I'm pretty sure they're sitting back and welcoming the challenge. Guess what? I'm sitting back and welcoming the challenge, too.
One of the points that you made one time when we were talking about the superstars of today that would be facing you this year, you said that one thing would be for sure, that they would be more nervous playing against you than you would be playing against them.
Well, I mean, based on what everybody's saying, no one knows what I'm capable of doing. I think they know in the past of what I'm capable of doing, but I don't think anyone knows what, you know, what type of style of game that I can play, and, you know, at what point will I get back into that zone.
Jordan, yes!
I'm not going out trying to face the superstars of today and try to outgun them, but the unknown is a scary thing, you know, and right now it's so much unknown about me. Yeah, that I'm pretty sure they're going to have to think about.
By White and out to Michael. Rejection in his way. His first shot tonight and the rebound by Hamilton.
The Knicks definitely have to box out better than that. I mean, if you don't have your best rebounder in the game, that's a bad sign. Everybody went to the glass, nobody touched anybody.
Michael Jordan takes it inside.
Leaving him to go and help one or other people, and Darren Jackson, though, making him take the shot.
Jordan for two. Shooting three-point shots tonight.
Well, that's good defense by Washington, making him shoot outside. That's not the Knicks' strength, is their outside shooting.
Talk about Michael Jordan's comeback. You know, it entailed more than just putting on a pair of sneakers and donning a new uniform. He had to shed about 35 pounds and polish 3 years of rust. His personal trainer, Tim Grover, is here tonight. I talked to him a few moments ago. He says Michael right now is at about 90%. He still needs to improve his first step, get more lift on his jump shot. And surprisingly, the biggest adjustment is flexibility in his right index finger. Remember, he sliced it after that sixth championship on a cigar cutter while celebrating and obviously taking a vacation in the Bahamas. He had surgery, and he complains right now that he can't get the shot off the way he did before. So that's what they're working on, flexibility on his finger.
Away with the quick hands of Shandon Anderson. Michael Jordan, his first field goal in the second half. it by Sprewell, the drive and the kick. Nesby has it and buries it from outside.
I still don't understand why they're going to let Latrell Sprewell play one-on-one. I guarantee you they won't let Michael play one-on-one.
Jordan has 19 points. Sprewell is on Jordan. Looking into Jones or Leitner, regardless, it's intercepted by Kirk Thomas and then retaken by the Wizards. Michael Jordan with Whitney's have the hot hand. Wizards down by three. Jordan for the tie. Rebound by Kirk Thomas. Built into the floor and a foul. Jordan's had some open looks. He has had a 7 of 21 display shooting from the floor tonight. And that's Jordan's signature. Late game big shots.
Well, right there, Michael had the good look for the three. Had good rhythm stepping into it, but you know, one thing as I've observed Michael throughout this game, I just don't think he's got the same, I mean, I know he doesn't have the same kind of conditioning. He's going to get better, I think, as the season goes along, but his conditioning is not what it used to be, that's for sure.
Well, we talked so much tonight about Michael Jordan, Latrell Sprewell, the man who had to guard him tonight. Obviously, you're happy with the win, but can you talk about what Michael looked like from a first-hand perspective guarding him?
I mean, he looked great. I think we did an excellent job. Our game plan was great. We pretty much wanted to keep the ball out of his hands, and when he did catch it, we put two guys on him, and we tried to force the other guys to make plays for him.
I guess you're not in playoff shape the first game of the year, but did you think Michael was tiring and he didn't have his legs like he did, say, 3 years ago?
I didn't sense him being tired. I thought he really made smart plays. And when you put two guys on a guy, you have to do the right thing and move the ball, and that's what he did. The other guys for him have to step up and make plays.
In the Utah Jazz, could you compare the feelings you had today to the feelings you had in your first game of your first comeback?
I guess the difference is I'm a little bit older than when I was the last time I shot the ball. Game's a little bit different. My teammates a little bit different. Obviously, the outcome tonight was a little different than what I wanted. But I feel good about myself, and I feel good about what the team did tonight. But we have to continue to work in the right direction. So hopefully I answered your question.
Michael, over here. Doug said that your knee was bothering you, hadn't practiced the last couple of days. Was there some rust from that layoff? And secondly, were you disappointed too that you only got 6 shots there in the second half?
My knee bothered me a little bit, but I felt good tonight. I didn't have any pain, no aching at all. Maybe that was why I didn't shoot the ball particularly well, because I wasn't able to shoot the last couple of days. In the fourth quarter, I was just really trying to move the ball ahead of the double team and the triple team at certain times. And early in the game, that worked for us. You know, guys, Rip and those other guys stepped up and made big shots. And we just could not execute in the fourth quarter.
You know, he's a great player, man. I mean, you know, Jordan at this age is better than about 90% of the players, you know, today. And, you know, he's so smart out there, and, you know, he knows the little things of the game.
He's a young kid, and I'm actually looking to come at me hard. But he's got to realize I'm coming to him, too. So November 7th should be a good game.
Here is Pierce with a step back and hitting the basket over Hamilton. Clock and under 8 minutes to go in the first. Jordan, look to Leitner.
Nice pass.
Mike looks 7 straight points run off by the Washington Wizards, and Pierce on the turnaround gets his second basket.
Because he knows
we'll see what happens by the time we get to All-Star game.
I was going to say,
here's Jordan.
Great. He looked terrific. And the native of Washington.
Jordan changes hands.
And Michael Jordan with a little vintage. He's a tough guy who can defend.
Jordan fouled by Pearson, makes the basket.
So from the field as Pierce commits his first foul of the game and a chance to bring the Wizards to within one.
Michael looks like he is fouled.
In the first half, Dick Stockton, Hubie Brown, Cheryl Miller. Pierce driving and scoring.
And he gives lectures. Now this is the side of this guy that nobody knows. Now that is a commitment 19
as the third scorer for the Wizards tonight. Pierce defending Jordan. Fall away, he hits. 29 for Jordan. Last seven. Doug Collins saying he has to be emotionally involved to play well. He's answered that question now. Here is Pierce driving in. Jordan defends.
Oh, that was an offensive foul.
The foul is called.
That was a good.
Let's get back to power basketball with Pierce and Walker inside. And here is Pierce, and Jordan is all over him. This is a good duel, and he knocks it away. Jordan gets the steal. Here is Lou, lays it in, and ties the score again. And they're guarded by Popeye Jones, and Pierce defended by Jordan. Here is Pierce and Jordan with seven on the shot clock, and traveling call to Jordan. I tell you, that's where the headiness of Michael Jordan pays off.
Right now, see, it's a story.
Anderson has size on him. Here is Jordan with a pump fake block. Pierce blocks it and gives it up to Walker, who gives it up to Johnson. And that's a big basket in this game.
Yeah,
you see the game clock as Walker turns around. It's a big shot with the defender in his face. After a slow start. Here is Whitney with the fake and the three, front rim, and Joe Johnson gets the rebound, and the rookie from Arkansas has 10 off the board. Traffic, here is Nesby for three, and the rebound by Walker, and the Celtics are going to capture this game and defeat Michael Jordan and the Washington Wizards, and that'll do it. The final score, the Boston Celtics 104, the Washington Wizards 95, and for Antoine Walker and Michael Jordan, season's high.
They started 3-7 one season, the Jazz did, but their worst beginning came in 1974, which was their first year in the league. They were 0-11 and then went 3-34, but finally got their fourth.
Now that was when they were in New Orleans too, right?
Right. 1974.
Four games that season.
And as I mentioned, Doug Collins, who Michael Jordan works one-on-one, waits, pulls up the jumper and hits. It looked like Stockton ran into a wall, didn't it? Heidi didn't move. Jordan fadeaway. Good. Matchup is Brian Russell against MJ. Russell reaches in, tries to knock it away with 2 seconds to shoot. Jordan baseline. Got it!
Well, you can hear the buzz in the crowd as soon as they saw this matchup here. Everyone remembers that picture-perfect ending, that last shot by Jordan, but he brings it back right in Russell's face.
MJ again. Got it. 12 points. The shot came in game six of the finals at the Delta Center on June 14th. With Russell in his face. Baseline, same play. Got it again!
Take a look at this last play at Washington's offensive end. Jordan and Popeye played a little two-man game. You can see the defense sloughing off to double up on Jordan.
Jordan shoots, hits another. Mike. Jordan inside, fade away. Yes. Score the goal. He'll try a free throw. Michael Jordan, 44 points, an NBA high so far by a player this year. That ties an NBA high with Nick Van Exel and Tracy McGrady, both of whom have hit 44 points.
On TNT comes to you from the First Union Center in Philadelphia as Michael Jordan brings his struggling Washington Wizards to the city of brotherly love. Wizards have lost 10 of 13 games and go against the defending Eastern Conference champion, the Philadelphia 76ers, who have finally found their footing. They have won seven and dropped six. And welcome everyone to Philadelphia.
Thank you. Michael Jordan is struggling with tendonitis in his right knee, an inflammation of the tissue that holds muscle to the bone. It bothered him all summer and was aggravated when he hyperextended his knee in a preseason game against Boston. Playing 38 minutes a game, it is getting worse. In addition to the pain, Michael has no lift or power. Now on the lift is on the jump shot. There's no consistency. Oftentimes you'll see the elevation isn't there, and as a result, the shot is coming up short. As for the strength, the classic move, the one he used against Brian Russell in Utah, where he begins to drive to the right, then crosses over to the left, he goes up and over for the fadeaway. That shot that was impossible to stop, that shot is now getting blocked. Obviously, Michael isn't making any excuses, but age and tendonitis are robbing him of his athletic ability and his strength.
Hamilton. And Michael Jordan hits the first shot on the turnaround.
Now, that was beautiful. Have to pay attention to Harper because he is very strong and very energetic. He's going to pick up a lot of garbage.
Michael Jordan did not go to the line last night, and he's been over 80% from there. Allen Iverson connects on his first shot of the game.
Well, Iverson's attempting 27 shots a game. He's only shooting 32%. Larry's on him because he thinks a lot of the shots are bad percentage shots. Well, let's see as we go through this year how it calms down
here. Here at the First Union Center, the Wizards beat the 76ers 90-76 back in November. They didn't have
out a low post game, and Michael, we said, is the only one who was. Oh, is this guy on fire?
Iverson is feeling it up, and it's won by the 76ers, and Iverson hitting the three. Allen Iverson now with 15 points. For Michael Jordan, who's sandwiched. Ball away by Jordan. Top shot at any age. And Michael Jordan now with six. Trying to stay with Jordan. Very pesky defender is Harpering. And Jordan goes right through everybody. A pick. Iverson defended by Tyronn Lue.
To clear out.
A reprise of last year's NBA Finals. And Iverson beats into the basket.
Foot. You know, when he has about 250 pounds on him, legit.
Jordan driving against Harpering. He got a step on Matt Harpering.
Was on the first team all rookie team.
Tied at 60. And George very nearly lost his footing, recovers and hits the basket. Here's Iverson, who does not have a field goal here in the third quarter, and now he does. His first brings the Sixers to within four. With eight on the shot clock, and there's Jordan. And now it's a 8-point game. In the shot clock, here's Jordan. In the low post, the turnaround by Michael. 29 for Jordan. 2-85, and here is Iverson fighting for the offensive rebound and tips it in finally. Season's high for Iverson of 40.
Allow them to pick up a quality player somewhere along the line.
And a huge win for the Wizards, and Doug Collins, a rare smile on his face as he applauds his team. If he was concerned about effort, he got it tonight in spades from the Washington Wizards, who, having lost 9 out of 10, have upset the defending Eastern Conference champions by a score of 94-87. Let's send it out to Craig Sager.
I mentioned your tendonitis at the beginning of the show. I know you don't make an excuses, but you've been icing it all day, stem treatment, anti-inflammatories. Is it going to get better?
I hope so. I mean, that's what tendonitis is all about. I mean, you know, I probably got to stay off of it for some time, but you know, knowing me, I probably won't stay off of it, and I'm just going to come out and keep, you know, if it feels good, I'm going to play. If it doesn't feel good, then I have to sit out.
After this big win on the road, Charles Barkley wants to know if the NBA will let us add some more Wizard games.
I don't know. If we play like tonight, I'd love to be on TV, but if we play like in Cleveland, I wouldn't want to watch us.
All right, thanks a lot. Let's go back to Dick and Yubi.
What a difference tonight.
There they are. Hardly made eye contact, though, once they hit the court. Let's flash back a dose of ESPN Classic, shall we? Chapel Hill, Michael Jordan hitting the game-winning shot in 82 against Georgetown for the NCAA title. And then at the age of 38, Michael Jordan as a Wizard. Sticking it early, hitting three of his first four shots, all jumpers. More of MJ in this game. Off the pick. 22 points in 27 minutes, 3 rebounds, 4 assists for Jordan. Let's flash back as a Tar Heel, Vince certainly at Hops, but he averaged just over 12 points a game in three seasons at UNC. And then at the ripe old age of 24, Vinsanity, a sniper. 18 of his 31 came in the first. Off the steal, Vin sending a message to Michael with his defense. Jordan had been quoted as saying that he thought Kobe was better than Vince because of his defense. Michael would later say and admit that Vince has gotten better on D. Anyway, there's one of two air balls by Michael Jordan. Then again, Jordan had trouble with his jumper at times, 5 of 17 from the field. As we flash back, Jordan hard to the basket for the Tar Heels. He averaged just over 17 points for Dean Smith. And then Jordan, welcome back to the NBA. Olajuwon all over him. Flashing back, Vince's turn. Back at Carolina, you know, when Coach Dean let him fly, he hit. And then Vince, back in this game, 31 points in 31 minutes, 10 for 23 from the field, 4 three-pointers, 5 boards, 3 assists. And look who's getting the foul calls now. Vince Carter. His Raptors are winners over Michael's Wizards. For a guy who said this game was no big deal, Vince Carter sure didn't play like that. Not when you score 31 in 31 minutes. Michael Jordan has led the Wizards now in scoring in 5 of 7 preseason games, but the Wizards are only 2-5 in those games. As for Carter, he's led his team in scoring in all 7 of its preseason games, but the Raptors are 5-2. As for reaction?
I think as an elite player, and you'll find that he's getting to that point, you know, you're going to have to be able to play both ends. You know, and that's a big challenge for him, and he's taking that as a challenge, which I totally appreciate. As a fan and as a, you know, as a Carolina grad, I want him to continue to improve as a player. So every now and then you have to look at challenges, and I think he's accepting it as a challenge.
Take a glance at the numbers in the first ever meeting between these two former Tar Heels. Jordan made 3 of his first 4 shots, but he missed 11 of his final 13. Vince was 10 of 23 from the field overall. On Carter, Jordan said, quote, his intensity was high, as it should be. When asked if he said anything to Jordan on the court, Vince Carter said no, not a word.
He'll turn 39 years old on February 17th, but Michael Jordan can still score, and Michael Jordan can still pack him in. The Washington Wizards lead the NBA in home and road attendance, and it's packed in here today for the first regular season meeting between Air Carter and Air Jordan. The first of 3 regular season meetings. Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Air.
Vince Carter today on facing Air Jordan.
He's not guarding me, and I'm not guarding him. So, you know, it's just, I just come out there and do my job night in and night out. That's what it's all about, you know. I have to get up and be ready to play every night. You know, of course, they're not Michael Jordan, but, you know, I still need to go out there and defend my man. So, you know, and right now I have to worry about Richard Hamilton. You know, he's the one actually doing the job for the team as far as putting the points up there. So, I have to worry about him.
From North Carolina, 6'6 forward, number 23, Michael Jordan. From Georgetown, a 6'9 center, number 55, Jahidi White. And from North Carolina, a 6'6 guard, number 15, Vince Carter! Ladies and gentlemen, the head coach. Welcome to the NBA on CTV this afternoon, everybody. Antonio Davis back to Alvin Williams. Vince Carter working on Michael right away. First basket to Air Carter.
Hey, wait a minute. I thought they weren't supposed to be matching up against each other. What's going on here, Rod?
Vince Carter, 3 ball. Yes. Used to do, at least not with the effectiveness he once did. Carter shakes off Michael Jordan and nails the 3.
And now 24.
Vince Carter wanted a foul on the play. Again, Michael up on him. Vince, a leaner, is good.
Now another
ball. Raptors ahead by 11. Carter will go to the line. He's fouled.
Excellent. Brown.
And Vince Carter is fired up.
Loses track of Vince Carter.
Vince Carter just hit a rainbow 3 over Michael Jordan again. 23 seconds left, first quarter, dominated by Toronto and this guy. And he's fouled by another Allen from North Carolina, Brendan Haywood. He's right up on him.
Ron Lewis is a guy that can be a real nuisance on defense. He will get in your face and hound you baseline to baseline.
Look at this. Carter, Jordan. Vince, a circus shot, rebound, got it! 38-34, 6 minutes to go before halftime. Vince, fall away, good!
All of a sudden, the aggression.
Before halftime, Vince Carter has 23 points.
Yeah, just another game. Check out Michael Jordan in Vince Carter's face. Now, he does a great job defensively right here. Cuts him off again, challenges the shot, but hold it right there. Here's the difference. The young Vince Carter just goes a little higher. See, Michael Jordan has the block out, but he can't get up like he used to. Vince Carter wants the ball and then softly puts it back up. Nah, just another game, Rod.
Defensively on Vince, 47-43 Toronto.
And Michael Jordan, quiet start, 9 points, looking to get his teammates involved. Vince Carter, 23, great start. Very aggressive early on, but Vince tapering off a little bit. Here's the famous number 23, Michael Jordan. Rod, he is struggling in terms of dealing with pain. I think it's pretty obvious watching him on the floor.
Thank you, Rod. Vince, an energetic start to this game. Were you a little surprised to see Michael on you as much on the offensive side?
That doesn't matter. You know, I'm out here to play. I don't care who's guarding me. I'm going to do the job for the Raptors.
From a team standpoint, as I mentioned, an energetic start. Bit of a lull here, though, in the second quarter.
Yeah, you know, that's what we have to avoid for us to be a good team. You know, we're going to stay, if we can be on top, we have to stay on top. And, you know, that's something we're going to address, I'm sure, in the locker room.
Okay. Good luck in the second half.
Very well over the last couple weeks. Ever since that game against Philadelphia, Vince Carter turns, fires, and misses. Olajuwon on.
Toronto Raptors, Rod, when you're talking about third quarter woes, talking about being aggressive and getting off a good start, is attacking the basket. Keep mentioning the free throw numbers. The Raptors have to look to find a way to get to the rim. Richard Hamilton picking up the foul that time, trying to keep Mo Peterson from roaming the baseline.
Morris Peterson has been in a sophomore slump.
And the Raptors really need him to step up and score. He's had a solid game thus far, 9 points, and of course doing the job defensively for the most part against Michael Jordan. The catch is, Rod, sorry, when you see the job Mo Peterson is doing, and here you see Vince Carter battling Michael Jordan. Michael getting that left arm up to nudge Vince Carter out of post position.
Michael has two fouls, Vince has three. Good pass inside. Alvin Williams was off balance when he shot it.
Takes over, and Vince also stays with the ball.
Lob pass to Carter, no good. Michael Jordan was right on him, and Alvin Williams' pass was too far.
Vince Carter upset on that play, feeling Michael Jordan had a hold on Vince Carter. And Michael's saying, of course I did. Hesitation and look at the rim, Rod. He completely froze Vince Carter and locked his feet.
18 points for Richard Hamilton, almost stolen by Jordan. Carter can't make a drop.
So you don't want to settle for that shot, Rod. Michael Jordan lunges for the ball, goes for the steal. That's an opportunity to take the ball to the bucket. Instead, you miss the shot. Jordan comes back at the other end and makes it. Step of Hamilton, giving him a little space, but when you do that, you have to have at least one hand up to try to challenge or bother that ball up, not make it an easy release.
Alvin Williams, Jahidi White with the rebound. Richard Hamilton has 20 points, Michael Jordan 15. Vince Carter has not scored in this quarter, still with 23 points.
Rod, Alvin Williams,
Washington Wizards, and you said, okay, that's a W. Nobody's saying that right now. They have won 5 straight games. Vince working on Michael Jordan. Right up on him. Carter with 8 on the shot clock. Forced that shot up there over Michael Jordan.
See, great defense by Michael Jordan. Taking the drive away, getting ahead of Vince Carter, and getting a hand up on the shot. And Michael Jordan is talking to Vince Carter right now. Vince doesn't look too happy about what he's hearing.
With 5 fouls, it's a gutsy move by Carter. Good defense.
No time to hold back. You want to play smart and with your feet. Just like Popeye Jones did on that play, Rod, you were
making the choice.
Right on cue. You made that comment. He's so good. Conscious of keeping that ball out of Michael Jordan's hands. That's why everybody's dropping down. That jump shot is now available.
Vince wants the ball. Posting up Michael. Spinning. In and out. Olajuwon was there, but knocked it out of bounds.
Records of their teams right now. This Wizards team has won 10 games after winning only 19 last year. Michael Jordan is the reason.
Vince Carter pops out, tries to drive on Michael.
Good defense from Jordan. Keon Clark, strong to the basket, high off the glass. Washington ball again, and Michael Jordan right there. Fighting underneath with Hakeem Olajuwon. Hakeem with rebound number 8.
And that last jump shot by Jordan, you could see the effect possibly of the sore knee. That shot very flat, hitting front rim.
Hakeem from the free throw line. Keon Clark rebound. Fresh 24. Vince Carter has not scored in the second half, by the way. Numbed by this afternoon's experience. 23 points in the first half and bageled in the second.
Well, Vince Carter himself in the first half has scored more points than the Raptors have put up in all the quarters. When you look at 18 points in the second, 16 points in the third, and 14 points so far in the fourth.
So what do you do with this Toronto Raptor team right now? Vince said that they've been playing awful. He knows it. He says we have to be patient, that it's...
But everybody knows it. That's all.
Richard Hamilton emphatically puts it down, and the Washington Wizards have come into Toronto and dunked the Raptors.
Richard Hamilton, big in this game, right? 27 points.
Michael Jordan and the Wizards have absolutely shut down Vince Carter and the Raptors in the second half. Morris Peterson with the basket. Toronto will lose its fourth straight. And Washington will make it 6 in a row for the first time since 1997. And their record will move to 11-12. Michael Jordan versus Vince Carter. Almost even Steven on the stat sheet, but the bigger number is in the win column, and it goes to Jordan's Wizards.
New York last week. He's expected to be out about a month.
And you can see Jordan not afraid to be physical with any of these players, denying Sharif the post-up position that he was trying to get. Michael eventually picked up the foul, but we've seen that over and over again. Michael not afraid to play these guys tough.
Nice rebound by Gahidi. It was interesting talking to MJ after the game in Toronto, where he said it took him at least a quarter to get used to Vince Carter and figure his rhythm out. And then once he did, he didn't have much problem playing defense on him, as evidenced by Carter's 4 shots. Nice pass. He misses. Getting back to that MJ story, he said once he put a hand in Carter's face, he said Carter couldn't see the basket. MJ.
Yeah, Mance. Jordan's signature, late game big shots.
Well, right there, Michael had the good look for the three, had good rhythm stepping into it, but...
points. He has the last 4 Washington field goals going back 10 minutes, but he had been on the bench for 3. Here comes a steal. Howard Eisley in the game for New York.
A lot of time in there.
A screenwell jumper and missed it. Somebody got a piece of it. He won points for MJ. The lead is back to 7. But Jordan all over Screenwell, baiting him to go to his left. Now he goes right, throws one up, misses. Lou has to
position himself just right.
Wizards doing a great job of switching off. But look at this. This is getting real physical. That's good stuff. Like a couple of Brahma Bulls, Screwell and Jordan, face to face and lock horns.
You're the one backing down.
Timeout.
Jordan not giving an inch, trying to deny the pass. Ooh. And you see Sprewell trying to get some spacing between he and Jordan.
Would have been interesting to see if he had hit Jordan with the ball here. Boy, I think he did.
I think he did catch a little bit, but he didn't throw the elbow, just brought the ball
in. And the backcourt. And the Wizards have gone from being a curiosity because of that man, Michael Jordan, to a legitimate playoff contender.
They're igniting this capacity crowd at the guard.
So the Knicks have a 9-2 lead. They double up on Sprewell. Camby takes it to the rim.
For the Wizards, it's their first eight-game win streak since back in the 1982-83 season. Nine straight wins is a franchise record, and they have done that three times. The last time was in 1978, November 14th through December 1st. So they're trying to match the franchise best nine straight victories. 70 pounds, made it back from torn ligaments in his left thumb. Haywood guarding Camby. Sprewell for three.
Davis Forte, of course, the three-point shooter, the former Knick. Good screen by Thomas to free up Spree, but he continues to miss fire.
Sprewell has been off. Oh. Let's see, it's Thomas up front now with Harrington and Sprewell.
Knicks in the doldrums offensively. Nothing happening for them now. Aggressive, good D tonight thus far. Sprewell trying to get on the books.
Thomas. A couple of weeks, very instrumental in the eight-game win streak.
Hamilton also a co-player of the week or the month?
Yes. Of the year. I'm not sure.
I'll say the month. Okay. For the weeks of the games that he had. Catapulting these Wizards. He can't be made himself small that time. Bringing the ball down, Jordan able to knock it away. Sprewell comatose this first half. Not scored a basket.
Here's Camby.
Lost the crowd. Crowd comatose as well. No action. Steal by Michael.
All right, here comes Jordan. Oh, the crowd reacts. The tip missed by Jones. Jordan tried to draw the foul, and he did. It's a charge on Sprewell, who is suffering through a very long night.
And the savvy of Michael vexing the Knicks previously with the steal, that time reading Sprewell's mind to draw the charging foul.
To 44.
The Knicks seem revitalized now, but now another foolish foul. Spree and Jordan going at it. We saw that last week down in Washington. Very pugnacious, both players, a lot of pushing and shoving going on. Let's take a look, the right side of your screen. Michael likes to post there. Saw Spree shoving, Michael shoves back.
And in this case here tonight, you know, Latrell Sprewell is frustrated with the 0-for-9, also does not have an assist. 46.
Whitney, one of their better three-point shooters that time. Jackson going behind the screen. Davis, their other good.
In that second quarter, they shot 4 of 19 from the field. Sprewell tried to give it back. He has been way off. A bad pass from Sprewell. Here's Jordan. Michael Jordan taking it to the rim again.
Davis has canned a couple from right there.
Sprewell, 0 for 10 from the field. Harrington keeping sweep the nation. The other factor, Clyde, 18 turnovers committed by the Knicks. You see the difference at the foul line.
Ward very offensive-minded now. Good job by Luke, frustrating him.
Anderson. Shannon pleased, and then here's it from the other side. Michael Jordan.
So that's why he looked bewildered. What?
Davis able to knock it away from Houston. Here's Jordan around Sprewell. That's been the one major difference this year. Michael Jordan has not been able to hit shots down the stretch. Sprewell continues to have his problems. He is now 3 for 16 from the field, and it's kind of a opportunity right here. Down to 15 seconds. Both teams over the foul limit. They're holding for a finale here. Game tied 83. Now Jordan, played by Sprewell, has the 5. Here's Michael firing and hits with 3 and 2/10 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter.
Figured that he would live and die with his missing of making this particular shot. Houston on him, Sprewell on him, but to no avail.
Watch the little shake right there, get up on his toes, and it's pushed through.
Trying to make it nine straight to equal a franchise record and trying to make it six straight wins on the road. They are on their feet at the Garden. 2-point Wizard lead, 3 2/10 seconds remaining. Jackson gets it in. Sprewell puts the move on Jordan, and he stepped out of bounds. That's the kind of night it's been for Latrell Sprewell. Now, Doug Collins takes a 20-second timeout. Turnover number 23 committed by the Knicks.
And that one, a ghastly one. Spree the culprit. And a tumultuous night for Sprewell, as that might be the coup de grace for the Knicks. Take a look for yourself along the sideline. Right there, unequivocally standing on the line. Michael hounding him into the turnover. Right in front of the Wizard bench. And right there, clearly well over the line with Spree.
Yes, no argument on the part of the Knicks. Actually almost stepped out. Now Jackson inbounds. Here's Houston for three, and he hits it, but it's all over. Doug Collins had told his players, no fouls, stay away, as the Wizards defeat the Knicks 87-86, and the Knick tailspin continues. Since Don Chaney
Jordan's got it against P.J. Brown. Jordan for his first shot of the game. That's the defensive assignment for Baron Davis. Jordan for his second straight shot. And his
so he will make some shots, but is it okay? Does it bother him to take it?
Just 2 of 11 after that. Beautiful move by Jordan.
Malon said he was surprised at some of the looks that he got playing against Michael Jordan. He's got to defend Michael.
4 for 4.
Far behind is Elvin Campbell.
Up by Jones. Wants to answer. Cannot. Tipped in. Jordan. Can't finish. Up by. He's got the rebound. Jordan lighting up the crowd, but rejected by Baron Davis. Unfortunately, there's a foul.
And rightly so.
Jordan. Still the only Wizard to score. Got the defense along the baseline, and now Michael says, I'll post you up. And score again. Couldn't get that one to go. And Michael Jordan comes away after his third rebound. Going for two more. Defense Davis, go to the hot hand. Oh, my goodness. Drew's assignment is Whitney. Now Jordan. McClure runs at him. Fouls him. Two more for MJ. Now Popeye Jones. Wow, playing guard. Feeds Jordan. And against a 7-foot defender. I believe there have been 4 or 5 different defenders. Doesn't matter to Michael. Hornets are doing that in the first half. Jordan on Augman. Jordan against Augman. Take two. On the back down and the scoop. Looking for 34 first half points. He got it. Hornets recovering transition. Jordan for three. Follows his own miss and converts. Wesley on Hubert Davis. Jordan in traffic against Barron. 43. Who says, I want to take Augman.
Yeah.
And 45 finds Jordan. Augman tries to prevent the dribble drive, cannot, and Michael has 49.
Yeah.
Broken fibula. Jordan. Jordan, 51 for Michael. Is the third highest point total ever against the Charlotte Hornets team, and he obviously leads to a standing ovation.
It graces Doug Collins, because as much as this is a comeback for Michael Jordan, it's also a comeback for Doug Collins. He and Michael, they like to.
Welcome back to Washington, D.C., as the Wizards and the Nets tangle for the first time this season. Knocked away from behind and fought for. Kidd comes up with it with 3 seconds to shoot. Three-pointer. No good. Jahidi is there. Martin knocked away from behind. And in both those meetings, in both those years, it's an 8. 10-second difference. Jordan with another steal. Jordan got it.
One shot blocker to another.
Jordan pulls up. Got it. Not. MJ leans in. What a shot. Jordan draws contact. And it goes. With Davis. Now back to Jordan with the rookie on him. Michael's fadeaway. Great shot. Doug Collins yelling, quick 21. Michael's got it. Jordan. And it goes. Into Michael again. Off the glass. Beautiful shot. What a move, Jordan. Oh, tremendous. Jordan fadeaway. Unbelievable. Washington by 11. And a steal by MJ. Nice move. He got another one. Wizards hoping to finish 2001 with their 16th victory of the season. Jordan again.
Average about 96 points a game. And they will not reach 80. So Washington getting back to that style of playing some solid defense and to 9 points.
Wizards average about 91 points a game. They get 98. Where moments ago, Michael Jordan, wearing a Washington Wizards uniform, received a thunderous ovation when he was introduced by Bulls public address announcer Ray Clay. Yes, a stirring homecoming to introduce the Bulls. They'd still be cheering for Michael Jordan. Here is our test over Jordan. Huge sports day in Chicago. Michael Jordan's return, followed by the Bears and the Eagles playing to get to the... And Hassel, our test, felt he could do better. He said he was too hyped up. And remember, during the offseason, our test inadvertently caught Michael with that elbow, injuring his ribs.
The jersey and the Wizards haven't even been close.
However, our test on the strip of Jordan. Here's our test. Ooh. Putting the move on Jordan. Little contact, but no call made. Lead on the Bulls in what has been a horrendous shooting first half. Michael Jordan.
Half. Kwame Brown hasn't played yet. He was chosen first in the draft.
The steal by Olive. Time win over the Lakers. The big one, a win over Milwaukee. A road victory in Atlanta. And a foul is called. It's an offensive foul on Ron Artest.
Personal. I mean, you know, if you look at Doug Collins as Artest deals.
Oh! And blocks the ball. Artest percentage. Bulls have a good shot. Artest. A guy's missing, but we're looking at
big body off him and makes it tough for Jordan to get started. Could be a foul.
Foul is called on Artest. Meanwhile, Jordan has missed his last five shots. He is now 7-for-21 from the field. And Artest is fouled out. Bill Cartwright, Michael Jordan, a little friendly pushing and shoving.
Michael will have a good laugh at this one only because they won this game. Artest certainly not happy at all after fouling out with 14 points.
Final seconds, and that, folks, will do it.
Mercifully.
The Wizards, 77, the Bulls 69. In a moment, we'll be chatting with Michael Jordan. Michael Jordan.
All right, thank you very much, Marv. This was a very ugly basketball game, but the most important thing when you're playing a game like this is to make sure that you win it.
It is. I mean, it wasn't a pretty game. I think both teams were pretty much hyped, wanted to play well. You know, a lot's been made about the game. Me, personally, I didn't play particularly well, but, you know, we won the game. We could somehow found a way to win the game, and, you know, that means most, you know, come back and win the game. But it's tough playing here. You know, I almost feel guilty playing against it. You know, with the fans and, you know, the appreciation that they paid to me early in the game, it's tough playing in front of them.
Do you think you will ever be separated? separated from the Chicago Bulls? I mean, you became MJ, great basketball player as a Chicago Bull. Now you're at the Washington Wizards. Will you ever be separated from this team?
No, I don't think I'm going to ever be separated. I mean, I have too many memories to try to forget, you know, when I leave here. You know, I think we're always going to be connected somehow, some way. You know, even though I'm working for another franchise, somehow I'm always going to be connected with the Bulls.
Wizards trying to get back to 500. Alley-oop Jordan, off the glass and in, and MJ has 40.
Jordan to run out of time. Here's Michael Jordan, and he gets 41 points tonight. He just broke to the hoop, got the pass, got...
Kate lays it up, no good. Popeye trying for the rebound, lays it back to MJ, and he's fouled.
That would have counted, too.
To give the Wizards the lead by one. Miller, alley-oop for Mim, he missed it. Gets the rebound and scores.
That was good.
So here we go with 1:06 seconds left. Wizards need the bucket for the win. Jordan the jumper.
Got it.
Yes.
They got it at the buzzer.
Jordan does it to Cleveland again.
Can you believe that? Oh.
Jordan is the Cavalier killer!
And no time.
What a shot by the greatest player of all time!
Just enough time to bounce that ball, set his feet underneath him, and bury, as you call it, the daggers.
Our Subway play of the day, Michael Jordan, who leads all scorers tonight with 26 points. He did it to the Cavaliers in the playoffs. He did it to Cleveland when he scored a career-high 69. And he's done it in his comeback bid here with the Washington Wizards tonight. The first of two meetings between the Wizards and the Kings. They'll play again a week from tonight in Sacramento. Kings lead the all-time series 90-73. They've won the last six times they've played. Last year, they won both games by 34 in Sacramento in January and by 5 here in February. The last Washington victory against the Kings, December 4th, 1997 at MCI Center, when Chris Webber played on the Wizards team. Richard Hamilton's first jumper went short.
Finesse.
2-point Kings lead. Jordan off the screen. What a shot. Here's as far as points and rebounds, but he's up there. Jordan, nice ball movement. Got it. Nice move. Jordan slams it in. Great. Jordan, nice move. Fadeaway got hit on the arm. Score the goal. He'll go to the line.
Started off 2-9 their first 11 games. That means six of Jordan get that shot.
Fade away, gets the bounce. 13 points in the half for Michael Jordan. On 6-9 shooting, MJ averaging 25.1 points a game. He's seventh in the league. Flips it up, no good. Lou to run. MJ, nice move. Off the glass, what a shot. And he's down and he's hurt. He hurt his knee. He's trying to get up to run it off.
I think it is he banged knees with someone.
He's trying to walk it off. Jordan hit the tough shot off the glass for his 15th point of the night, and here's another look.
And you can see as he gets in the air, he readjusts the shot.
Oh, his own man, Aton Thomas.
And the previous look before that was a great angle. You could really see him collide with Thomas. And he stays in the game, which is certainly a good sign. D-Bot, here's another look at this from high angle. Watch him hit right there.
Yep.
With Thomas. D-Bot's a 50. Jordan eyes the basket, fires, misses. Jordan's jumper a little short. 10 seconds to shoot. Jordan fadeaway missed it off the glass badly. 2 points and a half for Chris Webber. Jordan fadeaway misses. Terrific first half with 19 points. And that one's short. Rip goes inside, kicks it out to MJ. Wide open look at the bucket and misses. But look at Joe Jordan backing in on Bobby Jackson, fadeaway in and out.
Ooh, whoa. What Popeye lucky there.
Missed it. Popeye! MJ, nice move, goes strong inside, lays it up, no good.
More that timing of moving, being in the right place at the right time, happening more and more.
Wizards by one, Stojakovic in and out.
Oh, 25-1, that's the best at home. Not too shabby on the road, 12-10, but the one loss was an overtime loss against Dallas. And they've since then won 18 consecutive home games.
Pollard lost the ball inside, he got hit, no call, and a 24-second violation. Somebody not having a weapon. So tonight, the second of a back-to-back, and they play the back-to-back Sunday and Monday as well. Beating Minnesota and then losing to New Jersey. That snapped a five-game winning streak. Michael Jordan not happy about Phil Robinson's call.
Not an awful lot of contact, and not look like he was really controlling it. That's what great rebounders do. They expect every shot to be a missed shot.
Stojakovic on Jordan, fadeaway, missed it badly. Popeye's right. Brendan Haywood started tonight for Jahadi White, who's out with a sore throat. Haywood with 10 rebounds in the game. Nice back to a pass, knocked away by Jordan. Grand prize winner sees Washington play Boston back-to-back, complete with airfare and hotel. Enter now by sending your name.
Florio at the MCI Center.
What a way to go into this All-Star break. 5 consecutive wins, the last 3 against a pretty good basketball team.
I'd say so. Indiana, Toronto, Sacramento. The team, please, gives it up, and a slam by Gerald Wallace. 10 seconds to go, and it won't matter. Michael Jordan, Doug Collins, and this Washington Wizards club have brought quality pro basketball back to the nation's capital. In a shocking upset tonight, the Wizards knock off the team with the best record in the NBA, 108-101.
All right, thank you very much, Rip. Tonight, upset win over Sacramento, a big one. You couldn't have asked for more.
I told you, I mean, anything can happen with this team. I mean, you know, we're young, we're out there having fun, you know, and I think we're just playing hard, you know, leaving everything on the floor.
Back in the day, a team like this, you may have been a little tentative. You guys were very aggressive, and when Mike went out of the game in the third quarter, it seemed like you guys were having a lot of fun out there.
Oh yeah, we all started to get our rhythm back, you know, just pressuring the ball, you know, trying to get up and down the court, especially on defense, you know, I think that was the key tonight.
33 points, are you back? Are you healthy? Are you waiting for this All-Star break?
Oh wait, I mean, I'm not 100% yet, you know, it's still some things I can't do, but I'm getting better.
How about the job Popeye did? I mean, it's unbelievable watching the big guy out there diving all over the place, hitting every shot he takes.
Oh, he's a vet. You know, you get that out of veteran players. I mean, Pop surprised me with the dunk today, but he did a great job for us.
He did a great job, too. Congratulations. Rip Hamilton, big day for him. Back over to you, Buck.
25 for MJ. C-Webb had 21, but the Wizards improved to 26-21 with their 5th consecutive victory. Wizards basketball returns to Comcast Sportsnet Tuesday night.
Doug Collins was saying this before the game, and we got some more word on that from Craig Sager before the tip-off, but Kobe Bryant and Michael Jordan are probably a lot closer than a lot of people give credit for. I mean, they may be on different parts of the continent, but their friendship has grown over. From 20 down to beat Washington 103-94. As Kobe Bryant with a mesmerizing performance.
An excellent development where they'll make another step.
Let's remember, Michael Jordan came back. No one had any idea how he would perform. No one really thought the Wizards would be this strong at this point. Michael Jordan has been a remarkable player. As you mentioned, 25 points. 5 rebounds, 5 assists. Only Kobe Bryant has done that. 39 years old on Sunday, and the Wizards right in the thick of things with all of that.
Well, the sellouts around the league. Every game that they have played this year at home and on the road, a sellout. The people clamor to watch him play. Television ratings on all of the games, up. Attendance every place, up. He has been a godsend for the league. And he has responded by playing outstanding basketball for a guy 39. You hit the nail right on the head.
But the Wizards have run into another buzzsaw. It was the second half against the Lakers. It was most of his game against the Kings. And the Sacramento Kings have won their 20th straight at home. They are now 27-1 here at Arco Arena.
It's Strickland. On the drive, it's Grant for the jumper. Yes! With 1.4 to go, Brian Grant goes bottoms up.
Take money. Take money. Take money. Take money.
Although they're missing one of their key components, Richard Hamilton, who's been playing very well, out with that pulled groin. The injury was suffered last night late in the first quarter in a game in Orlando. Hamilton coming up with that pulled groin. Washington.
is going to collapse on him. Watch again. He gets down low, protects the ball, wedges his way to the back.
There's the end of a legendary career.